Namaskara. My name is Dr. Harihara Murthy. Pain in the ear can be due to various causes. In the winter months, people are sometimes going to have earache caused by exposure to extreme cold. If you see, the ears being exposed to extreme cold can cause ear pain starting from the external ear itself because of the vasoconstriction that happens in very, very cold climates. But in routinely cold climates like you have in winter months in the temperate zones, the northern parts of India, etc., you can have cold air hitting the ear, as a result of which you can get earache. A bad cold with a sniffle or nose block can also cause earache. Sometimes people with a cold while flying can develop a earache because of the negative pressure sucking the air from the inside of the ear. As a result, the eardrum is pulled inwards and put under pressure, causing intense pain. Infections in the ear also can cause earache. Especially during colds, one has to take care to prevent exposure to cold air. The nose and the ears being protected is a good way of doing it. But if you do have an infection in the ear, please do not take any chances. Ensure that you meet a doctor, ensure it is seen properly and treatment started so that we can avoid complications. So protecting your ear is best in cold climates. Secondly, ensure that the cold air doesn't hit the entire ear, not just plugging the ear with a cotton plug. Have the covering of the entire ear with a scarf or a cap. Ensure that you're not exposed to cold air so that air doesn't hit your nose, you know, when it's cold. These are small precautions one should take to ensure that they are protected against cold. If you have an infection, professional advice is advised so that you get the right kind of medication. Treating symptoms by just taking a painkiller is not the only solution. You may have to treat the cause of the pain, not just the pain alone. So please be careful about it and ensure you take the right kind of advice. Ear pain is a very common symptom, and sometimes in the middle of the night, if somebody gets ear pain, it can be very debilitating. A bad cold can cause a ear pain. Impacted wax pushed with the finger can also cause ear pain, especially if it is hard wax. Normally, wax will not cause ear pain, but if it's hard wax and you put a finger in or a bud inside the ear, you can get a earache. Using buds inside the ear can cause injury, and that can cause a ear pain. Trying to clean your ear without knowing where what you're putting in is going can cause ear pain. Loud noises can cause ear pain. Why? Because the impact of the loud noise can cause a rupture of the eardrum. A slap on the ear can sometimes cause a rupture of the eardrum and cause ear pain. Bad cold will cause a negative pressure in the nose and the ear, and consequently, the eardrum being sucked inside can cause earache. Infections in the ear can also cause earache. So there are multiple reasons why you get a earache, and each one of them have to be treated specifically with the specific kind of treatment. You can't use a wax solvent in the ear for an infection, and you can't use an infective medication to help pain reduce when you're having a wax induced ear pain. An eardrum rupture, drops are absolutely proscribed. You should not be using any drops in the ear when you have a ruptured eardrum. So there are different reasons why a person can get earache, and using drops indiscriminately for them are not advised unless it is given by a professional advice. Remember, eardrops are not to be trifled with, because there are lots of medicines in the market and the pharmacist may not know what is the cause for your problem. Taking the medication, you're doing it at your own risk. I've had people who had infections using wax dissolvent eardrops and having worse problems, sometimes going into chronicity and necessitating surgery. So it's advisable not to use eardrops unless with professional advice. Rupture of the eardrum can happen due to multiple reasons. The most common being a slap on the ear or an exposure to loud sounds like a cracker burst near you. Having said that, there are people who have been standing next to heavy-duty speakers during a concert also having ruptured eardrums. So these are the common causes. Apart from that, the use of things to clean the ear, whether it's a toothpick or a bud can sometimes cause ruptured eardrums. If you have a ruptured eardrum, the first thing you will have is intense pain. It's extremely painful to have a ruptured eardrum. Thereafter, you will have a lowered hearing in that particular ear. There may be a ringing sound which is caused by the concussion of the sound or the pressure which caused the eardrum to rupture. So in case of that happening, you will have a slight ringing sound or a buzzing sound in the ear. It is usually transient, spontaneously comes down, sometimes can be persistent. Some people may complain of transient giddiness after a rupture of the eardrum for the same reasons. So hearing loss, pain and giddiness with ringing sound in the ear are some of the symptoms of a ruptured eardrum. Most important thing is to make sure water doesn't go into your ear at all if you think you have a ruptured eardrum. Do not use eardrops, salt water, oil, anything for that matter in the ear because you feel you have a ruptured eardrum. The first thing is to protect it from anything going inside, because inside the eardrum, the area is technically sterile. So anything going inside can trigger an infection. So one should avoid it. It's essential that you avoid exposure to all things that can irritate the inside of your ear.